It's been 2.5 years since an earthquake and tsunami forced the Fukushima nuclear power plant offline. Well, there in Japan, we're now at a point where we have 300 tons of radioactive contaminated water leaking out into the ocean. They're pouring that out into the ocean. It's still a serious situation, and now the government's trying to step in. Well, after TEPCO's been trying to cover this up for ever since the beginning, it's pretty obvious that they don't really have this under control. Hey guys, it's August 8th, 2013. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. We were supposedly on a high terrorist alert. Al-Qaeda apparently was planning something big. You know, a lot of chatter. Wait a minute. A lot of chatter? I mean, if they really were planning something big, why would it be an increase in chatter? I never understood that silly terminology to me. I mean, here we have Al-Qaeda, a so-called terrorist group that was funded and armed by the CIA in the 80s to fight the Soviets in Afghanistan. And now we're supposed to believe that they only attack when it's completely convenient for the U.S. government. I mean, well, think about it this way. If Al-Qaeda was really an international terrorist group with all these capabilities, and they attacked us on September 11th, and, you know, they were still a threat, as wide open as our borders are, we have like tens of thousands of people more than that coming into this country all the time. How come they haven't been able to implement a terrorist attack? Okay, I mean, is it because U.S. security is just so great? You know, I mean, you know how easy it would be to have some type of attack? I mean, I think it's because they're a tool. They're a tool of the powers that be, and they're just used to scare people whenever it's convenient. And they're just used as a tool so that U.S. foreign policy, people who run U.S. foreign policy, can get whatever the hell they want, whenever the hell they want. I mean, that's basically what they are, at least to me, you know? So anyway, you have this, you have the United States government, well, a suspected U.S. drone attack killing six people in Yemen recently. And this is a sixth attack in the last, 10 days? I don't think that's helping our safety at all. I don't think, hopefully they only killed so-called militants, the Al-Qaeda militants, leaders within the organization. But it just doesn't seem coherent to me. Because you have situations like us using drones to supposedly bomb these type of characters. But then you also have situations where we overthrow the government in Libya. Right, a government that wasn't threatening us, a government that wasn't targeting the United States people or anything. You know, they're just working on becoming independent from the U.S. dollar, just like Saddam threatened the U.S. dollar by trying to sell oil in euros. You know, oil for euros, and that was a real issue. Well, they got rid of both of these guys, right? And now you hear out there in Libya, you have these radical Islamic fundamentalists, a lot of these people tied to Al-Qaeda, this Muslim Brotherhood type of groups, taking power, and it doesn't make any sense. Because, you know, in some ways, we sort of improve their position, these Al-Qaeda-like groups. But then in other situations, we're supposedly bombing other people, other members within the group. You know, what if there was a power struggle between the groups, and the government was using part of the group for its own agenda, and other parts of the group that were against that, maybe those are the people who are being targeted by these drone attacks. I mean, that's a little theory I just want to throw out there. You know, maybe there's a power struggle within these organizations, and that will sort of explain why we're bombing some and why we're helping others. And recently, Deputy CIA Director Michael Mora came out and said, hey, you know, if we get rid of the president in Syria, we're going to create a power vacuum that's going to benefit a lot of these Al-Qaeda-like groups. They're going to come in, they're going to take advantage of that. It's going to make us less safe. And I thought that was pretty accurate. You know, that's pretty much what I see what's going on right here. Also, you know, but at the same time, you have the NSA talking about, oh yeah, we're spying on people, but we're only spying on people who are linked or at least saying certain things that make them link to the people that we're looking at. Well, who are the people you're looking at and why are you looking at those people? You know, you know, and another thing, I think the NSA's spying strategy, in terms of spying on Americans, they're admitting that, yeah, we're spying on Americans, but only under certain circumstances. I think their strategy is to slowly tell people what they're doing over time. Like, yeah, we're doing this, yeah, we're doing that. And I think they're going to get people comfortable with the idea of them spying on us. And if they do that, then there'll probably be less resistance as opposed to a situation where, you know, it all just came out all at once. So I think they're purposely leaking some of this information to sort of get people used to some of the crap that they're actually doing. But anyway, what else is going on? Obamacare. Okay, so Congress wanted to exempt themselves from Obamacare, which is ironic because they actually passed it. And frankly, I don't think Obama or really anybody in Congress really read all of Obamacare. I don't think they really made it. I think the insurance companies made it, you know, because it benefits them the most. You know, telling people that, well, if you can't afford insurance, you should have to pay a fee for not getting insurance. Well, okay, let's think about that for a second. If I can't afford health insurance, how is the government gonna make things better by making me pay for it or pay a fee? I mean, really, just think it through. And then you had the employer mandate, which was a terrible idea. If you have over 50 employees and they're working over 30 hours a week, then you have to have a government-approved healthcare plan or else you're gonna have to pay certain fees. Well, that's gonna hurt businesses. That's gonna drive down unemployment. That's gonna create a problem. And it is creating a problem. They know it's creating a problem. So Congress, they wanna be exempt from this healthcare scheme. And recently, with approval of the president, they were able to get exempt. So they don't have to worry about losing their plans. But, you know, of course, all of them, not all of them, but a lot of them still want us to go along with the scheme. I mean, the hypocrisy is hilarious here. I told you about all those waivers the president put in for various groups, particular union groups. The hypocrisy is absolutely amazing. Anyway, as far as the economy, there's a little good news. Germany, their exports actually went up 0.6% in June from May. China actually saw a 5.1% boom in their shipments overseas. So basically, as far as exports, they're able to sell more to other countries. More of their own products to other countries. Also, Australia, they had a sort of a problem recently. They saw a drop in employment by about 10,000. 10,000, okay? Their unemployment rate is steady around 5.7. But the problem is that a lot of people have stopped looking for work. More people stop looking for work in Australia. So that's the situation there. As far as science news, there was a study, a University of Washington study in Seattle, and it showed that older people with higher glucose levels, blood sugar levels, were more likely to develop dementia. And this is based on a study of 2,000 people with an average age of somewhere around 76 years old. Thought that was pretty interesting. Also, a study on spiders. They actually studied spiders and they found out that a big factor in determining what type of jobs they get is really their aggressiveness, their character. You know, so they tested by blowing air at the spiders, and the bold spiders would freeze, but then go on the attack. But some of those other spiders, the ones that were tasked to actually get the prey, well, they would actually immediately go after the person who sprayed them. So I thought that was pretty interesting. I mean, maybe there might be some similarities with both humans and spiders. As far as, you know, SACF weapons sort of respond to some of the comments regarding that video, look, make the decisions that are best for you. Don't just get certain weapons because the military, the police have it. You gotta understand they have different capabilities and different needs than an individual during a crisis situation. So keep that in mind. All right, guys. Looking forward to doing more prepping stuff. My funds are being sucked up by, you know, obviously the taxes in the van. That's pretty much over with. Now I gotta worry about the house. Gotta paint the house and other stuff like that. But I'll try to get back more into that stuff as my funds allow. And anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.